Let's look at the demand curve again. What happens when price decreases from $2 to $1.50? Quantity increases from 1 to 2. From $1.50 to $1, quantity increases from 2 to 3. Notice that the dot just moves along this curve. In econspeak, this movement is called change in quantity demanded. When price changes, we say there's a change in quantity demanded. Remember, there are other factors affecting demand as well. Suppose we see this advert on TV today. Before you realize, there are more people wanting to buy apples at every price. Hey, apples are good for health. At $2, there are more people wanting to buy apples. At $1.52, at $1 too. Basically, at every price. So the entire demand curve shifts to the right. In econspeak, we say this is an increase in demand. What if we see this instead on TV? What? Apples cause diseases? Buy fewer apples. At every price, people will be buying fewer apples. So when people no longer like apples, demand decreases. Hence, the demand curve shifts to the left. Let's add graphs into the summary. When price decreases, quantity demanded increases. It's a movement down the demand curve. When price increases, quantity demanded decreases. It's a movement up the demand curve. When these factors change, it's a change in demand, so the entire demand curve shifts. When any of these factors change in respective directions, demand increases. So the demand curve shifts right. When these factors change the other way, demand decreases. So the demand curve shifts left. So far, we've been talking about individual demand. How do we derive the market demand? In other words, how many apples does the market want? If you like this video, remember to like and subscribe. Next up, market demand.